Today we face the monsters that are at our door and bring the fight to them. Today we are canceling the apocalypse.
Hello, and welcome to Plebpla. Today is the second part of a three-part trilogy of a two-part movie series that's supposed to have an anime coming soon, Winged Robot Wars. Today, we review the high-grade Bracer Pheonix brought to you by Bandai. This is a very interesting boy right here. He tried his best. He put in work. So, as is the norm, you get a nice five-page half-color manual. You get, of course, your regular warning and explanations for those that are new. I went through a few other manuals that have come out in recent years, and not all of those include that training page. So it's these, I guess, targeted, or I think Bandai is hoping to aim more at the American audience for selling their model kits if they weren't already, by making models of an American property. Of course, if you've watched the movie, you see that the unicorn's hanging out there at the end. You know, on loan from Bandai. So, let's just begin with the shortest of the boys, the Bracer Pheonix. From the top down, the head kind of, again, doesn't turn. He's got a little back and forth in there. It looks like he can just barely, like, tuck his head away like a little turtle, but no, not quite. The arms are a very interesting case. You do get that full swing in there, but you get no shoulder action here whatsoever. And then the bicep turn. Now, that could be something exclusive to my build right here. As soon as I pop this piece on, we're going to find out and try that on the other arm. No. The other arm does not get a full bicep rotation. It's super limited, and when you try to twist, it starts separating that bicep arm real bad. You need to lean back in. Your elbow articulation is a right angle with one singular joint. And then the wrist, well, the hand gets a lot of motion, but I guess that's because it's like half punch bot? Partial punch bot? I'm not too sure on that. And something about the arms, and I don't know, I've never looked at the Bracer Pheonix in high detail. I'm going to try to zoom in right there on the wrist. There's a gap. I don't know if that's part of Bracer Pheonix or if that's a design flaw. I don't like that gap being there, because then it shows where the hand plugs in. And further, the hand is a two-piece sandwich with opening gaps. These gaps are open. What is this? This is open. And not only that, it looks like it's designed as if it was supposed to have extra articulation there, and we didn't get that. Now, since this boy is asymmetrical, on the other hand, you've got a whole bunch of like extra guns here and this big punchy fist, but it's literally the same. There's the wrist gap, the bicep fucks up, the elbow joint seems to be fucking up, and then these, I would be extra careful with whatever these extra guns are, because I feel like those could pop out at this point. You kind of get some weird shoulder action in there, in that full rotation. I will at least observe that there's a lot of detail here, so much so that there's like shoulder rockets or probably smoke screens there. That's interesting. At the waist, you get this. The legs, once again, come all the way up, but they don't come up, they don't, this is the bend. Does it look like a bend? No, it doesn't look like a bend. These legs are, you can see the shape there. And it's very interesting, but it's very limiting that there is not design choices. Either, I suppose you have two options. You remain faithful to the design, or you make, what's the term I'm looking for? Constellations? No, that's not the right word. You compromises for movement. The feet, at least the feet have a whole lot of articulation, even a full twist there. And then on the side, you've got another little, nice little rocket pack. He's a very squat boy. And even with like the knees bent, he's still, like, it doesn't look like his knees are bent. He just looks like a squat boy. He comes with no alternative parts, or rather, no extra hands, no weapons. There are some SWAT parts in my hand here, and it's very difficult to see at this choice of using the distance set. I will see if I can pop this boy out of joint here. Underneath, I'll see if I can't zoom if that works. There are pieces here that are detailed, and very nicely detailed at that, to show the gun. And then on these are flat as if the gun were inactive. I don't understand what these pieces are actually for. Those seem kind of unnecessary, unless it's the tracks. Because then you have these two pieces, which are the barrels for the Vortex Railgun, which only project from the front. I can understand why, maybe if they made this bigger, they could probably get it to move around, because even at the back, you have what are the same, what's the term I'm looking for? Anyway, I will show you, because these are the tiniest and most losable pieces I've ever seen. This is like, you can't even see that in my hand. It's tiny, it's right there. And you plug in the rail guns, but they only plug in the front, not in the back. And then we get the same problem with the stickers that the Gypsy Avenger has. These stickers are extra thick and extra non-cooperative. I managed to mash the ones around the head, otherwise it would have been only two colors. And I put one here on the chest, and I feel like I put a fourth one on here somewhere. But at this point, I've even lost the drive to try to find it. I'm pretty sure I didn't. I have to get my void meter in here. So, with that, Zeon says, scrap it. This is the one of the three that you can really just skip on it. If anything, the one condolence is that it comes with a tiny, tiny minifig of Scrapper, which, you know, is to scale. But without trying, it's not like you can really stick them on anything. It has zero articulation. It's just a molded piece that looks like you'd be able to mount it somewhere, according to the way the back works, but actually, I might have to try that. I thank y'all for watching, and see you soon.